गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ मिसेस भामरे मैम फ्रॉम एस मिशन जूनियर कॉलेज नंदूरबार. स्टूडेंट, महाराष्ट्र स्टेट गवर्नमेंट हैज कम अप विथ न्यू इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक फॉर 12th स्टैंडर्ड एंड दैट इज फुल ऑफ इंटरेस्टिंग शॉर्ट स्टोरीज एंड नॉवेल्स एंड पोएट्रीज एंड जर्नल्स एंड राइटिंग स्किल. Our senior teacher Shinde ma'am has already introduced you with that course book, and today I am here to teach you the poem Indian Waves that is written by Sarojini Naidu. So let's turn to the poem. Before learning the poem, let's know something about Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu was sometimes called as Nightingale of India because of her poetry and the quality of the poetry, the meter and rhyme. So she was called as the Nightingale of India. Sarojini Naidu was a political activist, feminist, and she was the first woman president of Indian National Congress. She has written so many poems, and Indian Waves is one of the beautiful poem which we are going to learn today. So let's learn the poem. Waves waving at break of a day. Why do you wave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a Haitian wild, we wear the robes of a newborn child. See the first stanza of the poem. Waves waving at break of day. Waves, the person who wave fabrics. Waving at break of day. At break of day is a phrase. Means what? Morning time. Okay, weavers are weaving fabrics at morning, at break of day. Why do you wave a garment so gay? See here, poet is asking question to weavers, and what is the question? Why is weaving garment so gay, charming, attractive, beautiful? Why do you wave a garment so gay? The poet is asking question to the weavers, and see what is the weaver answers. See, weaver answers, blue as the wing of a Haitian wild, we wear the robes of newborn child. See, blue as the wing of Haitian wild. See the blue color. Blue as the wing of Haitian. Haitian is a kingfisher bird. Okay. Who has blue colored wings? Blue as the wing of Haitian bird. The fabric which they are waving, its color is blue. That symbolizes something special, loyalty, speciality. We wave the wing of Haitian bird. Means what? We are waving the fabric which has the color just like the wings of kingfisher bird, blue color. We wave the robes of a newborn child, and they are waving the robes of a newborn child, a cloth for the newborn child. Newborn child. The first stanza symbolizes the birth, life, happiness. If you observe this stanza, here poet has said, we were swimming at break of day. Break of day means morning time, that is beginning of the day, beginning of life. With new hopes, new beginning. Why do you wave a garment so gay? Blue as the wings of Haitian wild, we wave the robes of newborn child. If you see here, this first stanza symbolizes the beginning of life, the birth of life, the happiness. Life which is full with happiness, full with hopes. Let's turn to the next stanza. We were swimming at fall of night. We were swimming at fall of night. Why do you wear your garments so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green. We wave the marriage bells of a queen. See, in this next stanza, weavers are weaving at fall of night. See, the time has changed. Here, at the break of day, in the morning, the beginning of day, the beginning of life. And here, at fall of night, means what? Evening time. Weavers are weaving fabric at the evening time. That is, which symbolizes the adulthood. Why do you wave a garment so bright? Why do you wave a garment so bright? God is asking question to the weavers again. Why are you waving a garment so bright, colorful? See the answer of weavers. Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green. Actually, our adulthood is the stage where you will find so many feelings in your mind, where you will find so many ups and downs in your life. Just like, in fact, it is better to say that our life becomes colorful. Color of love, color of happiness, different colors will be there in our life, in our adulthood. And just like the plumes of peacock, purple and green. Just like plumes means what? Feathers of peacock. As you will find the colorful feather of peacock, like purple and green, the same. You will find your life colorful. That is the middle stage of life. We wave the marriage bells of a queen. Some important event happened in that stage. For example, marriage. The word marriage suggests such important events. We wave the marriage bells. Bells means what? Bells means thin fabric, which usually worn by women to cover their face, to hide their face. So, we wave the marriage bells of a queen. So, weavers are waving the marriage bells for queen. See, this plumes of peacock symbolizes the colorful life. Life with ups and downs. So many ups and downs. So this second stanza symbolizes our young age, our adulthood. Now, the next stanza. We was waving solemn and still. Why do you wave in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud. We wave a dead man's funeral shroud. See here, in the third stanza, the mood has been totally changed. In the fourth stanza, you will find the birth that symbolizes the birth that signifies the life. Second stanza symbolizes the colorful life, our adulthood, our young age. And the third stanza symbolizes the third stage of life, that is the last stage of life. Weavers are weaving fabric, but how? Solemn and still. Solemn means what? Unhappy, sad. The mood has been totally changed. They are waving the clothes, they are doing the same work, but they are unhappy, sad. and very still. What do you wear in the moonlight shoe? Means this is night time, moonlight shoe, night time. What do you wear in the moonlight shoe? What are you wearing in this moonlight? See the answer. White as a feather and white as a cloud. The fabric, the cloth which they are wearing is white color. White as a feather and white as a cloud. The color of that cloth, the color of that fabric is totally white. For what? We wear a dead man's funeral shroud. And what are they wearing? They are wearing the dead man's funeral shroud. Shroud is a cloth which is used to cover the dead body, which is used to wrap the dead body. So, third stanza symbolizes the death, the last stage of life. So, the first stanza, whole poem, this with the different stages of life, which begins with birth, then adulthood and death. Means what? Beginning with happiness and end with sorrow. Hi sampurna poem jar apan baghitli तर आपल्या आयुष्याच्या थ्री स्टेजेस दर्शवते. आपण जन्माला येतो त्यावेळी अगदी आनंदी असतो, त्यानंतर मोठे होतो, तरुण होतो, आपलं जे जीवन असतं वेगवेगळ्या रंगाने उधळून निघतं. दिस कलर्स पर्पल अँड ग्रीन. ओके, द अप्स अँड डाऊन्स ऑफ अवर लाईफ आर इंडिकेटेड बाय दिस कलर्स पर्पल अँड ग्रीन. अँड आयुष्याच्या शेवटी काय होतं? आपला मृत्यू होतो. सो इन दीज थ्री स्टेजेस ऑफ लाईफ वी वेअर जस्ट लाईक वेवर्स वी वेअर द क्लोथ ऑफ अवर लाईफ. तुम्हाला मराठी कविता आठवतच असेल, एक धागा सुखाचा अनेक धागे दुःखाचे, जरदारी ये वस्त्र मानवा तुझे आयुष्याचे. इन द सेम वे वी वेअर द क्लोथ ऑफ अवर लाईफ, द फेब्रिक ऑफ अवर लाईफ विथ सो मेनी हॅपी अँड सॉरोफुल इव्हेंट्स, सॉरोफुल मोमेंट्स इन अवर लाईफ. सो इन द नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ वी विल लर्न अबाउट the different poetic devices which are used by the poet in this poem. Have a nice day to all of you.